I'm Joshua Bardwell, and you're going to learn something today. I figured out what killed my Taranis, and I'm going to tell you what it was, and I'm going to tell you what I might have should have done differently to prevent it from happening in the first place, and I'm going to tell you how I fixed it. Stay tuned. A little while back, I advised you not to do the 5dBi Taranis pigtail mod where you put the pigtail inside the Taranis so you can have the detachable antenna. And I advised you not to do that because, not because the mod itself is fundamentally flawed. Many of you out there said, I don't know what your problem is. I've been doing it fine. Maybe you screwed it up. Ha ha ha. And in fact, if we look inside the Taranis SE, with a new special edition Taranis, which I that's what I bought to replace my busted Taranis, you'll find that the exact mod that I show you how to do has been done exactly from the factory. So the mod itself is not fundamentally flawed in any way. There has to be a way to do it correctly. But so many people were reporting to me that they were having problems with the mod. And my first thought was, yeah, well, you probably screwed it up. Just like some of you said to me, screw you. But the people who were reporting this to me were people who I know, just from my history with them, that they're skilled at soldering. I was confident that they did it right. And if they were saying to me, I did it and it's still having an issue, there has to be some kind of a pitfall there that even beginners could, especially beginners could fall into, even though many people were doing it successfully. And that's why I advised you not to do it. The other reason I advised you not to do it was because I knew if I made that video, I would get a lot of comments and be able to do a lot of research, a little more focused research into how people were doing the mods and what was going right or wrong with them. And I've come up with several theories as to why this mod fails for people. And I know which one of these theories relates to my specific radio. So I'm going to tell you these things right now. What was wrong with my radio was actually nothing to do with the radio itself. It was the antenna. When I replaced the antenna with a new one, all the faults went away. And in fact, I have since done a range check on my old radio with the new antenna, and it has the same range as the new Taranis that I bought. I felt a little silly when I found this out because I could have just bought a new antenna, but I was out of town and I really wanted to fly, and I kind of wanted to buy a Taranis special edition anyway. So it was a good excuse. Now I have two Taranises. Good. Oh, great. I am happy to report that no permanent damage appears to have been done to my radio board, even though I did not cut my cable to the, I think it's 84 millimeter length that Alex Grieve documents and that Mr. Steele shows in his assembly video. At the time that I did my assembly video, I certainly hadn't heard of that recommendation. Now that I understand why that recommendation is made, I definitely support it, and I would do it that way if I were to do it again. But for the time being, I appear to have escaped any permanent harm. What happened to the antenna? Well, if you look closely at an RP-SMA connector or an SMA connector, you'll see there's a male part that has a pin and a female part that has a little receptacle. And the pin and the receptacle are tapered so that they mate very, very precisely. Gigahertz level signals are not screwing around. You can't just treat them like DC electricity and just solder it up and who cares as long as it's got contact. You really have to have very precise impedance. If there's any impedance mismatch, you'll get a lot of reflection and bad stuff will happen. And what happens is these connectors, they're rated only for so many mating cycles. If we look right here in the Wikipedia entry for an SMA connector, it says SMA connectors are rated for up to 500 mating cycles. Notice the keywords up to 500 mating cycles. The cheaper SMA connectors that we probably see on these cheap antennas and cheap pigtails that I use probably are not capable of achieving that rating. Maybe it's much less. And in order to achieve that, it's actually necessary to properly torque the connector when making the connection. A 5/16 inch torque wrench is required, set to 3 to 5 inch pound feet. I don't have a perspective on whether that's a lot of torque or a little torque, but I have a feeling that most of us are over torquing our SMA connectors because we're all gorillas trying to keep things snug. And brass is actually a really soft metal, and it's very easy to deform it. I bet you that we're over-torquing them, and that further reduces their lifespan. Now, how often do you take your antenna off? Well, I actually take my antenna off quite a lot, because with that big old honking 5 dBi antenna there, anytime I wanted to put it in my backpack, my low pro quad guard, or if I was using the think tank sleeve, anytime I did anything like that, I took the antenna off. And I travel a lot, and I carry, you know, I was probably, I certainly would guess that I achieved 100 mating cycles, no question. So my antenna wore out. That's the answer. And if you have a Taranis and you're getting the kind of problems that that I describe, where you get random failsafes, reduced range, or even an antenna fault warning from the Taranis, then I suggest that the first thing you should do is you should buy a new antenna and see if that fixes your problem. And it very well may. For all of you guys out there who replaced your backboard, maybe you didn't have to. Ouch. But, you know, all we can do is gather knowledge and go forward. The other problem that I feel like it's necessary to call your attention to is the problem of electrostatic discharge, ESD. And I'm going to link you to a very educational and incredibly entertaining video from Electroboom. If you don't know that channel, it's a very, very funny channel about electrical engineering. It's educational and incredibly entertaining at the same time. And he has a great video about ESD. The bottom line is that you walk on the carpet and then you touch the doorknob and you shock yourself. Well, that can happen all the time, even at like microscopic levels that you don't really notice. And anytime you handle electronics, you're supposed to ground yourself before you handle the electronics, because you can apply static shock to them and damage them. The reality is that most electronics have special technology in them to protect them from ESD. Otherwise, we would just be damaging things through normal use. But the radio board that the Taranis has, I am told, does not have the kind of components that would allow, that would protect it from ESD. And the front end amplifier on the radio board has transistors in it that can be particularly susceptible to ESD. So when anytime you're working on it, the Taranis, if you're using a soldering iron, the soldering iron should be ESD protected. You personally, you should be using an anti-static strap, or you should just touch a grounded part of the Taranis when you're working on it to make sure you ground out, and that'll reduce the risk of any ESD when you're working on it. But there's a risk here that is not quite as obvious, and that is if you've got an RP-SMA connector, then anytime you remove the antenna, that signal pin is a risk for electrostatic damage to the board. It'll just, if you touch the signal pin without grounding yourself, potentially you could shock the internals and damage it. And so this is an interesting consideration. You can get a 50 ohm dummy load. I'll put a link to that down in the video description. If you have a Taranis and you're going to be removing the antenna, it might be a good idea to put a 50 ohm dummy load on the end of the connector to protect it from any electrostatic damage. And you might make a point of touching the outside of the RP-SMA connector to ground yourself just before you might accidentally come into contact with the signal pin. That might not be a bad idea as well. All of this being said, I have to acknowledge that this is not the complete picture. There's people out there who say that they have reduced range or damage to their board, even though they took full ESD precautions with a ESD strap, a wrist strap, and ESD protected soldering iron, and they're expert NASA engineers, whatever, they know how to solder, and they still have damage. So this is not 100%. This is not 100% safe modification to do. Then again, there's people out there who have a Taranis that they didn't mod at all. And maybe just some of them are going to fail in the field. I don't know. This is the best advice I can give you at this time for how to perform this mod and how to live with this mod safely. I do think this is a good mod to do. And FreeSky agrees with you. The Taranis Special Edition, which, by the way, I will be reviewing in an upcoming video since I know you're going to ask. The Taranis Special Edition comes with, literally, I've opened it up. I looked in it. It looks just like you or me or anybody did this mod. So there's nothing here to say that you can't do this safely, but you definitely want to take all the precautions that you can to minimize the chance of damage to the radio. And understand that, especially if you're removing the antenna and putting it back on all the time, eventually it will wear out, and that could be the cause. If you leave your board powered on after the antenna has worn out and is not making good contact, then you will burn out the radio board. And by the way, if you have your antenna off and you power the radio up, it really does not take, it takes only a matter of a few seconds before you can damage that amplifier. So definitely do be careful about this. And maybe now you understand why the original Taranis didn't come with a removable antenna, huh? You got a whole can of worms we opened here. Now you know what happened to my Taranis. Hopefully I've given you some good advice of what to do if you start getting these errors. Number one, first, just replace your antenna. Don't replace your backboard. Maybe replacing the antenna will fix it. And how to avoid damaging it. Thanks for watching, and as always, happy flying.